Welcome to Sabor Latino Global, SLG, the program that showcases Latin American talent in the New York, New Jersey metro area. SLG is not just a culture, it's a lifestyle. My name is John Hernandez, and I'm your host for today's exciting episode. Now, I know what you're thinking, but my name really is John Hernandez. You can thank my daddy for that. But today's show is a special treat for you. It's a special treat for me as well. That's why I wore my shell-toe Adidas.
Oh, my God.
No, you didn't. She's a New York-born B-girl. She's the one that New York B-girls aspire to be.
Or hate on.
Sorry. La Roca.
Right.
Also known as Rockefeller. She's known as Rockefeller for her breakdance mastery. She's performed as a teen in school productions and as in open mics, and later began to perform as a theatrical venues with her company Full Circle Productions.
Yep.
This is where she learned to get her voice to become a singer, a rapper, and a poet. Welcome, La Roca. We're excited to have you here today.
Thank you, John. Thanks. It's great to be here.
All right.
And you know, you look like somebody I know. Or my Uncle Raul or somebody like
yeah,
that.
Yeah,
you
that's
do.
What everybody says.
Nah,
she
you
wants
know.
Me. She wants me.
No, Latinos are mixed. We come in all sizes, shapes, and colors. You know how it is.
Well, look, is it okay if I call you Rockefeller?
Yeah, or Rock for sure. Rockefeller is like when I'm breaking, you know, rocking the fellas. And then La Roca is when I'm on the microphone singing or rapping. Or,
oh, rocking or the fellas.
Reciting
I got
a verse.
That.
Yeah,
I got that.
Yeah.
Okay,
so
then,
okay.
Rock.
Yeah.
Well, we're really excited to have you here. So let's get started. We got a little bit. You got a lot of accomplishments going on here.
Been busy, yeah.
You've been making your mark in the hip-hop world.
Yeah, little by little, taking it step by step. Obviously, yeah. As a dancer first, and then branching out into different things because of it. But yeah, it's been interesting.
Uh-huh, okay. All right, well, I got a couple of pictures.
Oh,
I got
no.
a couple of pictures of you.
Oh no.
Yeah. Let's take a look at the first one. This is Rock. Rock throwing down on the Brooklyn Bridge.
Oh yeah, I like that one. That's a good one. It was a good day. It was like in June or something like that. And they did my hair, we had makeup, it was kind of cool. And you know, I'm from the Bronx, but you know, I got love for Brooklyn Bridge.
Well, what's up with this guy? What happened? Did he fall off the car, off his bike? He was staring at you really hard.
I didn't even see him. I was too busy. Hoo-ha.
Uh-huh.
I didn't even see him, but yeah.
He was fixed on a baby girl.
It happens. It's not always you see a girl breaking, so I'm sure that when he saw that, he was like, did she fall? What's going on with her?
Well, the second pick is a pick of you training in the studio.
Oh, yeah. That's mm-hmm. definitely when I'm in the lab. I'm trying to, like, pursue different moves. And, you know, that move, I can do it in my sleep.
Okay.
No, not really. Breaking is not something you can sleep on. It takes a lot of hard work and focus and commitment. So I got my good days, I got my bad days, my talent all days.
Okay. So I understand that you started singing and doing poetry on certain lineups in theatrical venues. Is
I
that
did.
Where you found your voice?
Well, it's like, I think as growing up as a child, I always wanted to sing, but you know, it's like, ways. It's like a system out there that you have to kind of fit into, and I didn't really fit in, so dance was the way to go. And
okay.
then once I started to earn some credentials with that, I was in the theater all of a sudden, and they were like, well, we need a transition or interlude. And I'd be like, oh, I got a poem, or yo, I got a song.
Mm-hmm.
And they'd be like, sure, let's hear it. Okay, let's put it there, let's light it. And then from there, I started to pick up way more confidence in that area. So I started to go with it, hit some open mics, and you know, face the fire, because it's not always, you're not always gonna get applauded and be accepted, but it's good. It's good to have thick skin, and that's okay. one of the ways to get it.
Oh, cool. So if we put the light on you right now, you could just do a little freestyle.
No,
for
I don't
us.
Know about freestyle, but I can say something I wrote, you know? Sometimes you get props, sometimes you get dropped, sometimes your heart stops when you see how the other got down. They do it in your face with a smile or a frown. Everybody's waiting to see me lose ground. Easing the fever, squeezing the schema. Hip hop brought the dream back to the dreamer for redemption. I trade in my Benz or my Beamer. You know I can't afford neither. I leave it there.
See, that's why I wore my shoes.
It's the truth. I know, thanks.
I'm impressed.
It's
yeah.
a little song.
You have a very diverse little list of experience going on here.
Yeah.
You performed at various universities, Columbia.
Yeah. Yes.
What's going on? Columbia, Hostos Community College in yeah. Stony Brook.
It's been good. I mean, I think all these departments like to have people from the community who have succeeded, you know, because that also motivates the young people coming up.
Absolutely.
And there's like, you know, women's studies, there's, you know, Afro-diasporic department, studies and departments. So they like to bring hip hop or people of color to come in and talk about the real, like the reality of a journey, a career in art. So I've been blessed that way. I've been chosen to do a couple of things. And, you know, so that's just how it's gone. It's gone.
Okay.
One of my favorite things has been to perform for my community. So, like, when we did the Puerto Rican Day Parade, that was like, wow, I felt like I had finally arrived, you know, because Latinos love Latino culture. And when you bring hip-hop in, they're like, whoa, that's not us. But happily and luckily, I was embraced, accepted, and it was a pretty, it was an amazing experience to do the parade. So
out of all of your experiences, you know, in the clubs and, you know, all these festivals, you know, working at Lincoln Center. I mean, which one left the most lasting impression on you?
I think dancing for the Millennium celebration where Bill Clinton and Hillary Clinton were out and checking us out. And Will Smith had hired me and my husband to perform as, like, ambassadors of the breaking dance genre, because it was like the millennium was over, and so they had swing dancers, tap dancers, and all this other Americana. So me and my husband were chosen to represent breaking, so that I think was a big deal.
Wow.
Yep.
Must be rewarding to be such a to have such an impact on the youth and all your young dancers. What do you try to teach them? You know, serving as a mentor. I'm sure you're serving as a mentor at all.
Yeah, I do. I work in after school programs. I've presented some works, programs at like correctional facilities or hospitals, you know. So it is trying to extend to them this idea that you have the potential to do whatever you envision. Just keep going, don't quit.
Mm-hmm.
And also like study. I mean, and studying doesn't always happen in a classroom. It can happen person to person, it can happen you being exposed, like an internship or things like that. So it's just study, master your craft, and try to, you know, break out the box a bit and see what your unique contribution is, what's it going to be, and just keep going.
Okay. Now, I was told that you challenge your dancers on a regular basis, and you have a set of questions that you ask them just to keep them a little focused.
Yeah.
So I have a couple of those questions here. Do you mind answering them for me?
Not at all. Go ahead, shoot.
Okay. All right. So can you define your dance style in a scientific way?
Scientific? I think it's like the way centripetal force works, like, right? Like things, you're being pulled by gravity. The way what you put out is what comes back, right?
Mm-hmm.
That type of thing is what I would say dance or art is about. Or even just human, just life. You say something, someone's going to respond. Action, reaction, that type of thing.
Mm-hmm.
And because we work in a circle, right, we're always breaking in a circle. When you're in a cipher, spitting rhymes with one another, there's this call and respond that's happening. So you're constantly in conversation. And so I think that would be the science of it. But like on the surface, we really just want respect. We want to create new identities for ourselves.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes we're not happy with our environment, and so you can break out of that, but you really have to work at it, and there's a lot of rejection that comes with that. So, you know, trial and error. You know, I think that's what I would, you know, say.
Okay. All right. So, question number two: have you thought about the history of your style of dance that you've chosen to master? You know, its roots, external influences, the evolution of it.
That's kind of deep, and that's a really long answer, and I think, yes, right? But to put it in a nutshell for you, I would just say it's Afro-diasporic with European and also Asian influences. So.
Oh, excellent.
Yep.
Okay, that sounds good. All right, so I think that's going to be it for us today.
Cool.
All right.
Cool. Well, thank you so much for having me, and I hope to, check out the show later.
Now, thank you for coming in. So we're going to close out the show with some clips of La Roca and her dance crew. You guys did a performance at a Women's Heritage Month event?
Yeah, just last month. So enjoy.
Change the face of me.